Yahweh's people, let no joy, O come before the Lord, and pray for him on Calvary, and let the trumpet sound. See God used to mend the Lord, singing from his song, from bone and voice. See God used to mend the Lord, singing Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thought and in my word, and in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who taught by the Holy Spirit, we dare to call our Father. Bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me. Son of man, what is the meaning of this proverb that you recite in the land of Israel? Fathers have eaten green grapes. Thus their children's teeth are on edge. As I live, says the Lord, I swear that there shall no longer be anyone among you who will repeat this proverb in Israel. For all lives are mine. The life of the father is like the life of the son. Both are mine. Only the one who sins shall die. If a man is virtuous, if he does what is right and just, if he does not eat on the mountains, nor raise his eyes to the idols of the house of Israel, if he does not defile his neighbor's wife, nor have relations with a woman in her menstrual period, if he oppresses no one, gives back the pledge received for a debt, commits no robbery, if he gives food to the hungry and clothes the naked, if he does not lend at interest nor exact usury, if he holds up from evil doing, judges fairly between a man and his opponent, if he lives by his statutes and is careful to observe my ordinances, that man is virtuous. He shall surely live, says the Lord God. But he begets a son who is thief or a murderer, or lends at interest and exacts usury, this son certainly shall not live, because he practiced all this abomination, he shall surely die. His death shall be his own fault. Therefore, I will judge you, house of Israel, each one according to his ways, says the Lord God. Turn and be converted from all your crimes, that there may be no cause of guilt for you. Cast away from you all the crimes you have committed, and make for yourselves a new heart and a new spirit. Why should you die, O house of Israel? For I have no pleasure in the death of anyone who dies, says the Lord God. Return and live. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
A clean heart create for me, O God, and a steadfast spirit renew within me. Cast me not out from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
Give me back the joy of your salvation, and a willing spirit sustain in me. I will teach transgressor your ways, and sinners shall return to you.
Create a clean heart in me, O God.
For you are not pleased with sacrifices. Should I offer a burnt offering, you would not accept it. My sacrifice, O God, is a contrite spirit, a heart contrite and humbled, O God, you will not spurn.
Create a clean heart in me, O God. Please all stand.
Alleluia. Alleluia, Alleluia. Blessed are you, Father of heaven and
the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Children were brought to Jesus that he might lay his hands on them and pray. The disciples rebuked them, but Jesus said, Let the children come to me and do not prevent them. For the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as this. After he placed his hands on them, he went away. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
In our Gospel, Jesus said, "Let the children come to me." Why did he ask that the children come to him? Jesus in our gospel tells us that to these ones, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as this. ano ba yung halaga ng bata? Kung titignan po natin ang mga ebanghelyo, ang bata ay wala pong halaga. Hindi ho bilang. Kaya kung titignan din po natin sa ebanghelyo ni San Mateo, nung nagpakain si Jesus ng 5,000, lalaki lang ho yung binilang nila, hindi ho nila binilang ang mga babae at bata. At tingin sa bata, walang bilang. Sa atin, sa taga, sa Pilipino, saling kit-kit lamang. Hindi bilang, kunyari kasali, pero hindi naman. At sinasabi ni Jesus, sa mga katulad nito, sa mga maliliit, sa mga isinasang tabi, sa mga hindi binibilang, sa kanila ang kaharian ng Diyos. Sa panahon ngayon, gusto natin bilang tayo, may say tayo, may pangalan tayo. Pero kadalasan, ang tao na nais gumawa ng pangalan para sa sarili niya, aminin natin, minsan may mga pagkakataon na tumataas din ang ulo, lumalaki ang ulo. Pero kung alam niya na yung lahat ng biyaya na meron siya ay galing sa Diyos, pinagkaloob ng Diyos, marunong siyang magpasalamat. Kaya nga, hindi ba ang bata, alam niya kung hindi niya kaya. Malinaw sa kanya pag hindi na niya kaya. Di ba minsan ang bata magbubukas ng bote? At pag hindi niya, susubukan niya sa lakas ng pagka, ng kanya, sa kanyang lakas, kahit magbago na yung mukha niya, namumula na yung mukha niya, mabuksan lang niya yung bote, pero alam na niya kung hindi talaga kaya. Kaya ano ginagawa ng bata? Pag hindi niya nakaya, hahanapin yung sino mas matanda sa kanya, iaabot yung bote na yan, sabihin, pakibukas. Kung susal yung bata, open. Alam niya kung ano yung kaya niyang gawin, alam niya yung hindi niya kayang gawin, at pag alam niyang hindi niya kayang gawin, hindi siya naiiya na humingi ng tulong. Minsan pag tumatanda na, akala niya kaya niyang gawin lahat, tingin niya siya yung papalit kay Superman, kaya nangyayari, kahit hirap na siya, ayaw niyang humingi ng tulong. Bakit? Pride ko to eh. Pride ko nakasalalay dito, hindi ako hihingi ng tulong eh. Pero ang bata, na lumalago sa pagpapakumbaba, alam niya yung limitasyon niya, alam niya rin kung hanggang saan ang kaya niya. Hindi siya nagpapanggap na malakas, hindi siya nagpapanggap na kaya niya, he knows when to ask for help. At ang tao na maliit din sa paningin ng Diyos, hindi nagmamataas, alam niya rin na ang Diyos ang tumutulong sa kanya. Kaya maganda rin bilang deboto ng mahal na pong Jesus Nazareno, at tayo rin mga pilgrims na nagtutungo dito sa simbahan, at mga pilgrims sa ibang bansa na nakikiisa sa ating pagdiriwang ng Eucharistia. We look to God with trust that we know we can run to Him when things get heavy for us. When we say, Lord, hindi ko na kaya, Lord, nabibigatan na ako, pwedeng lumapit sa Kanya. Pwedeng magpatulong sa Kanya. Dahil ang bata, alam niya kung hanggang saan lamang siya. Pero hindi siya sumusuko. Hindi siya umaayaw. Pag nahirapan siyang buksan yung bote, hindi niya biglang ibababa at sabihin niya, ayoko na, hindi ko nakukunin yan. Hindi siya sumusuko, pero humihingi siya ng tulong. Maganda rin para sa atin bilang Kristiyano, sa ating paglago sa pananampalataya natin, alam natin na may mga bagay na nabibigatan na rin tayo. Pero kaya rin natin sabihin, Lord, mahirap na, pero hindi ako aayaw, tulungan mo ako. A child always asks for help. And the child knows when to ask for help. Sa matingin natin kahinaan, pero sa totoo lang, ito'y kalakasan. Kasi ang tao na kayang aminin ang kanyang kahinaan, kaya niyang aminin ang pagkakataon na kailangan niya na ng tulong, yun yung totoong malakas. Kasi alam niya that he cannot exist on his own. He needs the help of other people. Ang taong tingin niya kaya niyang gawin ng lahat, nasobrahan ho yata ng hangin yun. Ano? Yung tao, tingin niya, kaya ko yan, alam ko yan. Kaya kong gawin ang lahat ng yan. Nasobrahan ho yata ng hangin. Ang tao maliit, marunong magpakababa. Ang tao maliit sa harapan ng Diyos, alam niya kung kailan hihingi ng tulong. Ang taong maliit sa harap ng Diyos, walang maipagmamalaki. Dahil alam niya, kasama niya lagi ang Diyos. Katuwang lagi niya ang Diyos. Kapiling niya lagi ang Diyos. Kaya ito magandang paalala sa atin. Tulad ng isang bata, maliit sa paningin. May kanya-kanyang kahinaan. May kanya-kanyang limitasyon. Pero ang taong, ang bata din, alam kailan hihingi ng tulong. Sana tayo din bilang Kristiyano, huwag tayo mahiyang humingi ng tulong sa Diyos. Alam natin na pagkasama natin ng Diyos, hindi niya tayo pababayaan. Alam natin na pag tumutulong sa atin ng Diyos, ay tutulungan niya tayo. Hindi tayo nag-iisa. Hindi ka nag-iisa sa pagbitbit ng problema mo. Hindi ka nag-iisa sa pagbitbit ng, o kaya sa paglalakbay mo. Hindi ka nag-iisa. Kasama mo ang Diyos, kapiling mo ang Diyos. Tutulungan ka niya. Huwag ka mahiyang humingi ng tulong sa Kanya. Kasi alam natin, hindi lahat, sa lahat ng pagkakataon, kaya natin ang lahat. Maging tulad ng isang bata, mapagpakumbaba, maliit. Maliit dahil nagtitiwala sa Diyos. Amen.
Please all stand.
With confidence, we come and present our needs to God our Father, who loves all His children, as we say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church of the Homes may be built on unselfish love, and that families may know and understand the depth of God's love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That married couples may be sensitive to each other's needs and find true happiness in their lives together. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That parents may bless their children with attention, caring, and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That children and those who have considered weak in our society may be supported by those who have more in life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That eternal peace be granted upon those who have died. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, your kingdom belongs to little children. Hear the prayers of your children who trust in you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and all the goods of all His holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In Him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in His fullness. For though He was in the form of God, He emptied Himself, and by the blood of His cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore He has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey Him, has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please all kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please all stand.
The mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please all kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Para sa lahat ng tatanggap ng banal na komunyon, sasagot po tayo ng amen, pagkasabi ng pari o ng lay minister ng katawan ni Kristo, at isubo agad sa bibig bago umalis sa harapan ng pari o lay minister. Sumunod po tayo.
Sa kanya. saya nagmumula ang aking pag-asa at kaligtasan.
Pagkatapos na misa, wiwisikan po ang lahat ng banal na tubig. Pinakikiusapan ng lahat na manatili lamang muna sa inyong mga lugar. Sa Quezon Boulevard o Plaza San Juan lamang ang labasan ng lahat. Sumunod po tayo. Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagdalaw at pagsisimba sa Basilica Minor at Pambansang Dambana ni Jesus Nazareno. Please all stand.
Let us pray. May the communion of you in your sacrament that we may have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Blessed are you, Lord, O God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. You have given us your only Son to be our way to you. Make us follow him generously, faithfully, and lovingly. Merciful Jesus of Nazareth, you have revealed God's grace and unconditional love for us at the cross. You set your church in this world, from which the true light would shine for all to see. Grant that we who enter this holy shrine may walk in your ways as disciples of justice, peace, mercy, and hope. We offer our prayers for the sick, the oppressed, the youth, and those in most need of your mercy. Hear our humble petitions. Bless these religious articles, that we may be fervent in prayer and charity. As we continue our journey as your pilgrim people here on earth, may we set our hearts on the road to heaven, our true home and reward, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Cristo Padre Jesus Nazareno, sinasamba ka namin, pinipinto ka namin, aral mo ang aming buhay at kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, iligtas mo kami sa kasalanan. Ang krus mong kinamatayan ay sagisag ng aming kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, pinarangal ka na amin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, pinulwalhati ka namin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, pinarangal ka na amin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, pinulwalhati ka namin.